Howdy, folks.
Hope y'all are doing well. So, let's get on with the business of continuing adventure number two, The Wrath of God. So last time we had managed to make our way through the first of the maps, and then do a little bit more on the second one. So, at this point, we are in pursuit of the Germans. And we've been running into the Brotherhood a bit more. So we've got 9 fuel, which should be enough to get our way there. We might stop by at this trader on our way. We'll see what the future holds. Strange iridescent crystals line the path. You stop to investigate the weird mineral formations when you hear the sound of engines. You sneak forward and soon discover a unit of unsuspecting German soldiers who have also stumbled across this bizarre crystal forest. I don't see that it really benefits me to withdraw. I mean, we won't have to fight, but then, I mean, I get resources from fighting too, right? Okay, so we have 2 attack dogs and 3 shock troopers. Everyone's level 2 except for this poor bugger. So, shock trooper here, here, and here, sort of spread across the middle, and then the dog at the back and up front. So we have the advantage, so we're going to be able to do a full turn before doing anything else, although I'm not sure to what extent that will wind up being useful. I like positioning up here a little bit more, so that's precisely what I'm going to do. Hey, Matafino. How you doing? Putting Miguel up here because he's kind of slow. So, Baron will have... Oh, that's actually a thing. So if Baron takes up lodgings here, then he'll get a straight shot on this guy. Unfortunately, we're going to be in range of the dog, which is not something that I want to do. However, I could put him here. The dog won't be able to get close enough, and we will still get a 65% shot at either the shock trooper or the dog. Although that's another option. I don't have any cover up here. Yeah, I don't have any cover such that I can make it that attacking the dog would make any sense, because it's just not gonna happen. So I guess the question is, which one would I rather take a crack at? So I get 7 armor shredding here, and then a bunch of... I mean, I can move, and then I can see. If I can kill the dog in the one shot, then I'll do that. Otherwise, I might just shoot at the soldier. Morning, BDA. So yeah, we're gonna lose a lot because of the armor. And here, yeah, we don't actually have any chance to kill the dog in one shot. Yeah, doing well enough. And busy with work. Considering buying this based on stream? I've been enjoying it so far. I don't know whether or not it'll stay that way. It's kind of a weird thing. Because I think I all too often with video games think about my enjoyment of something as being something that I think about at the end of having enjoyed it. Which is to say, you know, with a movie or a book or something like that, maybe it makes a little bit more sense to have that sort of wrap up at the end. It's like, yes, I really enjoyed this. But it's entirely possible for me to enjoy a video game for a while and then to cease enjoying playing the video game. But I don't really think about it in those terms commonly. I tend to think of it more of a, like a holistic evaluation. Which might be the wrong way of going about it, but I guess that's how it is. Okay, I can't take cover here, because the dog will be able to get there. And the shock trooper will definitely be able to shoot at me. I'm not sure there's a great place for me to move up. Let me take cover behind this explosive barrel. I wonder if moving here wouldn't be the worst. I don't think this guy will be able to move enough, and I'll still have cover from this guy. I mean, if he decides to stand around in the open, then... I'm interested to see what happens if I place this person here. And I'm not taking cover there. Guess I'll move Natalia up here. I could have had her sprint, but... well, too little, too late. And I suppose I'll have her heal herself while she's sitting at maximum bravery. This is fun. Yeah, this guy doesn't have enough range. But yeah, I mean, I like this kind of style of game. I've played a lot of XCOM back in the days, and this is a lot more, like, small scale compared to that. I also remember spending a lot of time in a real-time tactics game, Commandos, but this definitely feels a lot different than that. Hell, Commandos is almost a puzzle game rather than a tactical game in some ways. Okay, so... I like the idea of throwing a grenade. I'll be able to hit both the dog and this trooper. Value! Aha! Kill two enemies with one attack. So the shotgun's not terribly good against armor, and I need to be careful about advancing with this dog here. It might actually be the right play for me to withdraw behind cover here. Wait for the dog to come out, and then deal with the shock trooper after that point. Do that to keep him a bit stuck up. Tempted to move Natalia because she does have quite a bit to move, but all of the places that I want to put her are not super great. Dog won't get to her here, but then really I'm only just giving her a 53% chance to shoot somebody. Okay. Though these guys have shotguns, I think, and she doesn't have a lot of armor at the moment, so I'm just gonna have her stay put. Good job, Nazi. Oh, yes. Commando is one of the first PC games you ever played. Man, I guess it's a classic at this point, isn't it? So this is a terrible position. Not only is this guy not in cover from any direction, but he's standing right next to the explosive barrel. At least this one has cover because of the explosive barrel, but... I mean, I'm just going to blow it up. So, man, oh man. Yeah. So, okay, so I'm gonna have Natalia scientifically discover what happens when she shoots this. Mm-hmm. Duly noted. And then here. Okay. So I'll have old Piranha do the shotgun blast. And that'll be that. Cool. Well, that panned out. Rip Doggo. Yeah, I know there's, there is actually a... Here, I'll show you in a second. So we've got a monocle, some supplies to replace the one grenade I threw. Leather wallet. Sorry, a worn leather wallet and a leather wallet. So there is actually an option in here. Yeah, dog friendly mode. Disables dog sound effects, hit die sounds, dogs disappear instead of dying during combat. Which obviously I do not have enabled. Does nothing to shield us from the horrors of human conflict and war by turning a blind eye to them. So, Pereira can use bait, which I haven't really gotten a lot of traction out of. Natalia has bait. Which, I mean, I can perceive it being useful, I just haven't used it yet. And then, yeah, there's warning shots. I think if I had to choose between the two, warning shots is better. Maybe. Six of one. I have used warning shots before. I have not used bait yet in a way that has been effective or useful. I actually don't remember if this uses up ammo when you use it. I would imagine so, but... sure. Okay. And we've reached level 5 for the science. Medkit range? That's kinda cool. And we have pistol range and disintegrator range. So, I'll be honest, there is something somewhat appealing about using the disintegrator. I almost wonder if I should try this out. So I think one of the reasons why I was not super jazzed about using it is the whole, hey, it's minus 15% accuracy thing. But it does more damage, and it has much higher armor shredding, plus it does corrosion rather than standard damage. And the minus 15% accuracy doesn't actually matter if they're not protected by cover. At least I don't think so. Which is to say you receive the 100% chance to hit if they're in the open and not behind cover, so I don't think the minus 15% accuracy applies at all there. Plus there is the special skill that you get when using a disintegrator where it fires along like a line until it hits a wall. So the range here, which is 6 tiles, is actually much longer with special skills. Extra range for one of these does seem like it would be pretty cool. Though, yeah, I can't discount the idea of having an additional range on the medkit as being useful. I guess the problem that I'm running into here is that I actually want to play around with the disintegrator and see, hey, how good is this? And then, if I really like it, I mean, I've kind of lost on this one. I'd want to see whether or not specking into disintegrators would be something that would make sense. So I think what I might do is, for the next combat, I will hold off on leveling Natalia up. She's still going to gain experience. And we'll see how we do with the beam rifle. Also, hey Omniflare, and Ekamai. Okay, let's move on. A group of nomads are camped in the shade of a few shrubs. They are armed, and some of them are bandaged. When the men see you, they take up their rifles. You stare at each other for a few tense moments, then their faces relax. Inserting commas in my speech everywhere. Foreign soldiers cross our pastures. They draw from our wells and take our goats as they please. When he says they take your goats... Nope. It's better to not ask questions. They laugh loudly at our complaints. The proud warriors of our tribe waited in ambush as they crossed the ravines of the wadi. We shot six of them and disappeared before they knew where the shots came from. Our tradition of hospitality is sacred, but nobody shall abuse it with impunity. We are a free people, and we will fight when our freedom is trampled on. Okay. And on we go. As you drive around the next dune, you meet a fully loaded Wehrmacht truck. Coming the other way, the truck makes a tight U-turn in a frantic attempt to escape. We'll definitely follow the vehicle. You gun the engine and take up pursuit. After a frantic chase, you finally catch up with the Germans at some ruins. The soldiers hastily take cover as you move in to attack. Tumult? Yeah. Okay, so we have 3 Teslaborg. Two medics and a battle hound. Okay. I'm assuming the Teslaborgs are going to be using disintegrator rifles of some sort. I will want to do away with the medics and the hound as soon as possible, I would think. So, we don't have a lot of great cover. I don't want to stack up here because we're going to be really close to these guys. If we stack up here, though, well, we can scatter throughout this kind of cover, I guess. So I'm going to put Natalia here, because she can actually move faster. Baron, Miguel, Emperor, we'll stack up here. They won't be able to shoot at us or attack during this turn, so being out in the open isn't going to be really much of an issue at all. Woof woof. Okay, so the hound will be able to move a very long distance. So if we're taking up cover like along here, then that's not bad. This is as juicy a target as you get. So, I'm wondering if I take up cover here. Yeah, I will certainly be able to throw a grenade that far. Okay. It's kind of unfortunate that I don't like this guy's setup as far as skills are concerned, because burst fire is an AoE, but then throw grenade is also an AoE. So throw a grenade, we can throw this right on top of the medic, and we'll hit all three of them. Dude. I mean, that seemed to work out. Okay. If I move here, this guy's still going to have cover. Yeah, see? I still get the 100%. Though people behind... it's like 30%. Wow, that's terrible. So meltdown damages all units in a straight line until it hits an obstacle. Each successive shot reduces the remaining damage by 40%. So I could have her sprint over here and then... disintegrate these guys. We would need to follow it up, though, with, some additional... I mean, he can sprint. He can also come down here and stab them. Honestly, I'm kind of tempted to make this play. I can't, actually, because I need 2 bravery to use meltdown, and I need to use 2 for the sprint. I just need to get, like, right here. That would be really good. I'm not gonna be able to do that. So... I mean, I can disintegrate the medic. Which sounds like fun. Actually, yeah, this works out really nicely. So... here's what I'm going to do. So the Baron will move here. And then... knife might not be enough, so we'll bleed. Oh, he dies anyway. And then Pereira can move here. And bleed this guy. That might not actually be enough on the next turn. But we'll go for it. And I do want a clear shot on this guy, so I'm going to put myself out to do it. 22 to 26. Plus 10. Wow. There goes this frickin' staff ring. Oh! Okay, so this is... so it's going through cover objects as well. Like, this is low cover and it just goes straight through and... I mean, that's pretty sweet. Yeah, not quite enough. Free shots on Baron. Goes his armor. Very unfortunate. But yeah, I guess the really cool thing about this is that, like, okay, he's right there, but like any distance away, I can just straight up do that. That's really powerful. I like it. And it doesn't use standard ammo. Okay, massive leather wallet, silken handkerchief, worn ammo box, and car fuel. Excited, you searched the storage box as you found the back of the truck. Hot diggity. Okay, so let me think about this. So increasing the range of the disintegrator, in some ways it's actually not even that important. Because of the special attack. Not that you can always be using it, but yeah, it's one of those things to think of. Extra damage is nice. I'm kind of tempted to change this to the extra disintegrator damage. For this, though? I mean, extra range is useful. She's the only one with medkits, though. Let's go with that. Extra tile. Never know when it'll come in handy. Okay. Soldiers were camped here some time ago, but now a layer of desert sand lies over the abandoned camp. Are the soldiers surprised by a sandstorm? You search the crates for anything valuable. Worn sock suspender. Delightful. More fuel is always welcome. Cool. Let's go to this unvisited location. The village looks run down and deserted. You see a small plume of smoke rising from the courtyard of a caravansary. This is not a word I am familiar with. I mean, its meaning is obvious, but... You decide to investigate and run straight into a unit of German soldiers who have set up camp here. So we can draw our weapons, or we can stay calm. For a moment, you stare at each other dumbfounded when Baron suddenly takes a step forward. I'm glad I found you here. Lieutenant Mueller of the Casablanca office reporting a covert prisoner transport. A weather-beaten sergeant rises behind his field table and looks Baron up and down suspiciously. Lieutenant Mueller, hmm? Stand to attention when you address a German officer. The soldiers jump to attention and alarm. Baron clears his throat vigorously. As I was saying, I'm glad I found you. Tell me, how well supplied with fuel is your unit? The sergeant struggles for words as Baron slaps him jovially on the shoulder. Splendid! I will have high praise indeed for you in my report. Excellent. Well, we get some free goodies. And we'll hit up this trader before heading back north. Okay, so we can buy this splendid bulletproof vest, which allows you to use intimidation event options and gives you extra willpower. A new battle dress, which is also heavy armor and a little bit better. Might not be a bad idea to just grab some fuel. This is a really nice item, though, and I do have cash to spare. I think I'll buy it. And the fuel. Okay, so the Baron is out of armor. I could give him the light assist or the worn assistant coat to replace this. Natalia is in a similar position, which kind of sucks, but we'll just do that. And Baron has a level up as well. So, we can make or increase his accuracy with sniper rifles. Give him extra crit chance, knife crit strength, or give him 5 extra light armor amount. Interesting. So I think here, knife crit strength is the one that I value the least. It's just not the one that I see as being the most overall useful. An extra 5 light armor is nothing to sneeze at, and we could potentially add in another 7 here. However, 12 extra crit chance with the rifle is pretty good. That's substantial for crit chance. But another 10 accuracy isn't too bad either. And what this will really enable me to do is shoot people at long range behind cover with high consistency. Which I really quite like the idea of. You know, there definitely are times where, you know, positions and moving on a target is not optimal, and I'd rather just shoot at them if I had a reasonable chance of hitting them. And I think that combined with this, which gives him extra 2 range with the sniper rifle, might just be the way that I'm interested in specking him out. Powerful attack, tripling damage done to the enemy's armor. That also seems really good. And I already have a couple with first aid, so I think I will go with this. I'll get the extra accuracy. If these are bad picks, I can always swap them out. I know from the main menu, or there's somewhere where you can basically reset your perks for about 2 grand or something. I mean, it's not cheap, but something you can do. And I guess we'll go here. I already have a full team, but let's see what happens. As you approach the village, you hear the shouting of an angry crowd. A furious mob has gathered in front of one of the houses. You make out the village chief and speak to him. What's going on here? The men have caught a con artist in the act, and now they want blood. You assess the situation. Isn't that Omar? He also recognizes you and waves frantically. It's all just a misunderstanding. Get me out of here. So we can either pay money to get him or continue your journey. I'm kind of curious. I don't know, like, if you have a full team, do you get any kind of benefit for rescuing someone even if you have a full team? Time for some science. Perhaps compensation for any losses will calm things down. You can try, but it won't be cheap. Don't leave me here! Sighing, you gather your funds together and pay. I mean, I could swap him out for Pereira. He does have the needle and thread, and he can use repair on other people, too. Being able to repair armor is kind of nice, and Pereira in comparison, well, I mean, he takes less damage. And that's basically it. Prayer is more of like a warm body than he is someone that's really adding value to the team. Not to say that, you know, he's not doing stuff. Hey, Seagull Backslash, thanks for the luck. Prayer touched the Stargate. No idea what it did. Oh, it did this. He's been kissed by the eons, so his vitality has gone up by 1. Temporarily, so it'll last until the end of the adventure, but no further. Okay. Well, I guess I'll ignore Omar. You can deal with that situation yourself, buddy. And I guess we'll rest up. You come across a small oasis in the endless sea of dunes. A few hardy palms provide some shade. This would be a great place to take a break. You spend a long break treating your bruises and greasing your weapons. Rested in good spirits, you pack your things, leave the oasis. Yeah, the discount stargates are no good. The bunker is a scene of a desperate struggle. The narrow passageways are choked with the bodies of soldiers. They must have trampled each other in a stampede to escape their fate. None of them made it. Inside the bunker, you cautiously sneak up on the creatures that wrought this carnage. A large group of them are sniffing excitedly at the soldiers' remains. They do not seem to have noticed them. Wipe them out. All of them. So we have the advantage, and we're up against quite a few. So there are a number of zombies scattered throughout. There's one infected down here. and two cultists in the central room. This is kind of rough. So there's definitely low cover to be used here with the tables. And then we've got these walls right there, so that will give us some kind of cover. I'm going to want a couple on station on this right side to potentially deal with, like, all of... to deal with the infected. And then to maybe come up here, open up a second flank. Okay. So the infected and the cultists have ranged attacks. And that's it. So these are the two cultists, because they don't have any armor. And the infected is this one. Okay. Let's put... Natalia and Baron here. And then I'm going to put Miguel here. And little Piranha down here too. So this zombie does have cover from this particular position. I don't have range if I'm shooting from here, which is... it's kind of pathetic. But there aren't other ranged attackers, so I don't really need the... Well, this cultist could do something. Let me see. So we won't be able to shoot this one because he's behind a pillar. And Natalia can't either. And our capacity to ambush here is pretty poor. So we'll have a 75% chance to shoot from here. We could cover this cultist. This one has a long way to go, but he can ranged attack quite far. And I'd rather not give up a choice position if I don't have to. So instead, I could just shoot this guy. Damn, this shotgun range sucks, though, you know? And I don't want to be this close. Okay. Yeah, and I can't shoot him from here. Well, let's put Miguel here. Could shoot at the zombie, but there's no reason to open up on him. I do want to deal with this infected. Okay, it's not enough to get the job done. Well, Pereira's got, like, some super heavy army, or armor, and he does take less damage, so I feel not that bad about hanging him out to dry. He can repair his own equipment if need be, too. God damn, that damage, though. Percent is not an odd that I like to play with. Gonna move Baron here, and then we will vanish. So he's in a little bit better position to engage enemies. Next turn, and I'm not just hanging him out there to get hit with knives. Hmm. Really? I want nothing more than to run up here and shotgun this guy right in the face. Not quite enough damage. This is kind of a rough position, to be honest. Hmm. So I could move Natalia up here and then use the disintegrator to hit across one of these two ways. So either taking out both these zombies or something. The problem is that I'm putting her in a rough position to do it. I mean, I could kill this guy, and then... Well... Yeah... Can I... These guys, I think they're on the same axis. Okay. Time to make some plays. So we'll move Pereira up here. We're going to blast the cultist. And then going to take Miguel. And move Miguel up here. Where we are then going to engage in a burst fire on these two. Natalia can move here, where we will now do the meltdown, which doesn't finish this one off because of the reduction in damage. And then, I guess... That was probably not what I wanted to do. So you can do that. Gruesome. Okay, so zombies can eat corpses to regain health. Lovely. Add that to the list of things I definitely wanted to know. Yeah, it's pretty nice. I like the range increase. Cool. The disintegrator sounds like a fun weapon. It does seem useful. Though not to discount the pistol, because the double shot ability is pretty good itself. So we have a Warren bulletproof vest. What? Porphyry? Cartouche? Curved shaving knife? This looks like some sort of spear rather than a shaving knife, if I'm quite honest. super manly. Shave with your spear. Shaving Naginata. That's how they do in Japan. Okay. On a rise ahead of you, you spot a lone soldier with his back to you. You sneak forward quickly and easily overpower him. Now you crouch behind the Wehrmacht jeep and survey the site below, an improvised German camp. It signs this guy to the side of the road. Its size suggests it must be a base of some importance. A soft groan tells you that the soldier has regained consciousness. So we can attack the base, interrogate the man. We can take a wide detour around the camp, or we can intimidate the soldier. Radio operator. We were ordered to set up a radio station here. Please don't hurt me. I'm just the radio operator. Well, that checks out. I was just looking for a better place to set up the antenna. Radio operator, huh? Listen, you're gonna drive us into the camp in your car, understand? Miguel sees the defiance on the soldier's face. I can be very unpleasant when I don't get my way. The man caves in. Fine, what do I have to do? A few minutes later, your vehicle enters the camp without incident. Behind the wheel sits a nervous German radio operator with a gun pointed at the back of his neck from under some blankets. The soldier stops right next to his radio tent. You knock him out with a sharp blow to the back of the head, then you slip into the empty tent. You search the tent in frantic haste. Apart from a small field radio, you don't find anything of interest. Then your eyes fall on a waste paper basket next to the field table, full to the brim with radio transcripts. Interim report on the Ararat expedition. To the Research Battalion Near East, we are gratified to announce that we have also encountered outposts of the target culture in the Armenian Highlands. The Valkyrium network is therefore considerably larger than previously believed. It should extend at least from the African Atlantic coast to the Caucasus. In the north, as is known, to the Russian White Sea. What? We will keep you informed about any further findings. Heil Hitler, Colonel von Ortzen, expedition leader. Hopefully someone doesn't clip that. You climb back into the Wehrmacht jeep and leave the camp at an inconspicuous pace through a gap in the perimeter by the latrines. Once you've passed the next sand dune, you slam your foot down on the accelerator. Well, I guess it's off to Anatolia for us. You can use medkits outside of battle by right-clicking them on the team screen. Okay, so apparently I was wrong. You can definitely do that. Damn it. This raises a question for me, then. You breathe a sigh of relief as you finally leave the merciless heat of the Syrian desert behind you. The awe-inspiring mountains of the Armenian highlands rise before you. Legend has it that Noah landed somewhere here with his ark as the waters of the Great Flood receded. But what is the connection with the wrath of God? I have no idea. What possible connection could there be between the Great Flood and the wrath of God? Someone hasn't read the Bible. Instinctively, you look up, but the mountain peaks around you do not reveal their secrets. You take another long break before you set off on the last leg of your journey. So then, can I do this? Because, yeah, you can use repair kits in combat, can be used to restore armor, each use of this. So, hang on a second then. Can I just use this in the inventory? Oh. Oh. Mm-hmm. Yeah, well... Yeah. It's a big map. So we have another recruit over here. An unvisited location of some interest. A little town here, some traders, and some other unvisited locations along the way. I think I'll take the left route and I won't do any doubling back. I mean, I have 15 fuel, so I'm doing quite well in that regard. But, yeah. We'll head this way. In the middle of the road, you find an old map. It is completely undecipherable. You keep going. This is a big map. I do want to visit this one, though. Oop. Take a short break when a sudden shot shatters the silence. Fountains of sand explode at your feet. You immediately take cover and scan the rocky landscape with your eyes, but you cannot see the shooter. You rush out to scour the surrounding area, but your search is in vain. Warily, you continue your journey, but the mysterious attacker does not strike again. And we got to pet the goats! The village ahead of you is inhabited. You hear the bleating of goats and children's laughter as you approach. The village merchant beckons you over to his stall. So, I think this is equivalent or the same or worse as the grenade I have. We can get a new Bowie knife or a tarnished Bowie knife. Crit chance plus 5. It's pretty good. So I'm gonna grab some more fuel for the journey. And I'm not gonna spend this kind of money on the Bowie knife. It seems like it is an upgrade for sure. But not a really big one for the kind of money that I'm throwing out for it. The military camp in front of you appears deserted, but you are suspicious of the silence. You approach carefully and walk right into a Nazi ambush. A detachment of soldiers emerges from the tents with weapons drawn and mocking grins on their faces. I'll give them something to smile about. We are blindsided. So, Nazi Trooper 3, Nazi Trooper 2, Sniper 3, Sniper 2, and a shock trooper way over here. Okay, so this guy has cover on this. This guy does not appear to be next cover of any sort. So, which one is this? This is the 2, so that's 48. I kind of want to capitalize on the positioning as much as possible. Okay. So these two are in the open. I want to take advantage of that. So I'm going to put Natalia here. The Baron. I'll put here. Miguel. Miguel, I'm going to put here, I guess, or here. This is a sniper two, right? Yeah. Put Miguel there, and then Pereira here. Okay, so we're gonna shotgun this guy. For great justice. Then, let's see. Oh, this guy isn't in cover. That is interesting. I thought... Yeah, I just assumed that he would be in cover because of all of this garbage that's right here, but yeah, I guess that's the spot of cover. That's unfortunate. Because this guy is definitely in cover. Okay. So I'm not going to be able to one-shot this dude. But we could two-shot him. Or we could do away with the Nazi Trooper 3, potentially. Can't capitalize on any of my AoE abilities. Okay, I want to take this guy down. And then here... I mean, we could take a gamble and throw a grenade at one of these guys, because the grenade will do enough damage to bring someone down, potentially. And I think that's a gamble I'm comfortable with, so let's try. Oh, man! Are you kidding? This guy's one health. Ambush will be his undoing, and then this one doesn't get to do anything. Okay, so... Yep, so we'll sprint here. And then... That's that sniper done. This guy has cover up and down. And quite a bit of armor. Nice. Okay, no line of sight from here. 50% to shoot from here, and also from here. Rats. Do this. Okay. So we get Natalia to move here. And that's going to be a hell of a lot of that armor gone. A good chunk of damage. This guy's gonna die this turn, so I don't really need to worry about cover. Oh. And that's that. Sweet. And for our trouble, we get a stylish assistance coat. Plus one to reflexes. Three supplies, medium ammo box, and some more fuel. Now we're doing science in style. Yeah, so reflexes will increase her evade chance, which is pretty cool. And we may as well equip Baron with the new assistance coat, and then we'll send this one packing. Sweet. What do we got? Over the next dune, you stumble across a dried-out riverbed that runs right across your path. Its rocky edges drop so abruptly that a crossing is out of the question. Annoyed, you drive along the steep wadi until you finally find a flatter slope that allows you to cross. Beyond the next sand dune, ancient walls rise abruptly from the desert sands. It is a deserted temple. It does not take long to uncover the entrance. Set out to explore the complex, and run straight into a German ambush. Guess it's not that deserted. Oof. This is a rough starting position. So we have a trooper here. Sniper here, in an excellent position. Shock trooper here, and an attack dog right there. I think the dog is actually behind, like, something that's going to protect him from things. I think heading up this way and into these little corners are going to be useful. And possibly also executing the dog. So, let's put Natalia up here. Baron up here. I'm gonna put Miguel here. And Piranha over here. So the question is, okay, we can hit the attack dog from here. So, I'm going to do that. So this is not cover, which is unfortunate. They're both getting a little bit of cover here, but they're going to be vulnerable. Like, if this guy takes up position here, then he'll be able to get a straight shot. Same thing with the trooper. We'll have to see what they do, though. Anyway, I definitely value taking this guy out before anything else. And then I'll put Baron on ambush. Question is, which of these two would I rather ambush? Both of them are soft. They don't have any armor. This guy can move further. And this guy, not as much. Well, let me think. So this is a low piece of cover. So if I do this, then I'm going to be taking an ambush shot when he comes behind the cover. I'll still interrupt the sniper, which is, you know, possibly a good thing. However, over here, I don't think there's any cover, so if this guy runs out here, I'm just gonna get, like, a free shot on him. And I think I prefer that, so. Okay, then. So this guy's covering Pereira, I guess? Yeah, hi. So come over here and then shotgun this guy right in the face. Finish this guy with a good old stabby stabby. As the ambushes go, that wasn't very bad. What do we get for our trouble? Painkiller, some cash, and a small ammo box. So the painkiller is not as good as the penicillin. Two combat uses. Yeah, I mean, it's just straight up not as good. A military camp. You peer carefully over the ridge of the dune. A large unit of German troops are camped just beneath you. They've secured their camp with sandbags and are patrolling the grounds. Further back, you can see military jeeps and stockpiles. You look at each other. This won't be easy. Okay, so we do start with an advantage, but we'll see whether or not we can play it into one. They're really spread out. The closest enemy is the Shock Trooper 3 up here. And then we have a dog. Yeah. The other Shock Trooper? Yeah. Officers on the other side of the camp. And then the other two dogs are sort of with the officer. It's kind of a rough layout. Not even sure who I would even want to go for here. Taking out the officer earlier rather than later would be good. I'll be able to take a pawn shot at this dog. So I think perhaps... Let's see. So put Natalia up here. Baron... I'll put down here. So that I can optimally see if we can engage the dog. And then Miguel. And Purr. I could swear I read some different numbers on that. Damn it. Okay, well, Baron is going to get munched on, I guess. So, she can move up far enough to engage him. Okay, and so can Miguel. Pereira, on the other hand, So I can move him down here and then use warning shots, possibly, to stop the dog from biting Baron. Or, you know, not do that. Natalia take cover on this. She can engage this guy. I hope this is enough to actually kill him. Yep. Okay. Nom nom. So, is Baron bleeding? Yes, he is. And he will be for at least another turn, which is unfortunate. So, Prayer can come down and deal with the dog. I like the idea of moving up here and then bleeding the Shock Trooper. Where did the other dog run to? Here. Okay. Because I don't think that it's going to be enough just with this. Yep. Well, we can also just crit. That works too. Okay, so we'll move here, and then finish the dog off with a knife. Yeah. Okay. And then here? Yeah, I don't have the range on this guy. And I don't know... Yeah, I don't think I'll be able to blast through that with the disintegrator. But... why don't we find out? No, the tent counts as a thing. okay. Jeez, dude. Probably want to heal him. <laughs> 75 and 100 to hit. I'll take the guaranteed damage on the officer. The dog can run all this way, which is kind of unfortunate. If I move here, then I have a 100% chance to attack either of them. Okay. So we'll move Miguel here, and then huck the grenade. Finishes them off, and then... we'll use the disintegrator. More painkillers. An iron cross, some cash, large box of ammo for that 4 that I was missing. Deeply needed. So what do we get from the... oh. Okay. Never mind then. Oh, right. I was going to say it's... use this on Baron. And we'll heal him up. Trainer. The merchant has pitched his modest camp in the shade of some palm trees. So we have a sheepskin vest, which is nice, but expensive. A sniper rifle I'm uninterested in, and then some other goods. Oh man, 10 grand. Sell the painkiller. And buy some fuel for the journey. It's kind of interesting with the whole, like, adventure unlocks, in a sense. Because, like, if I was in a position where you know, oh man, I really need fuel. I could come in here and basically claim these. Almost feels a little bit like cheating. Yeah, like 5 supplies. I should probably just take this. So I will. The other stuff, I will leave it right where it is then. So, the improved Steiner Pistol 34. 37 to 41 damage. Does less armor shredding. Standard damage. The accuracy is better, though that's because of her perk. And also because of the accuracy reduction on the disintegrator itself. Magazine size is 7 for 7. Crit damage also gives her additional agility, which is pretty nice. And it does more damage. Though I do like having more damage types that deal with armor. So despite the fact that this is actually quite a good pistol, I might still use the disintegrator. I do like that agility though. I'm not gonna sell it right now, but hey. Aw, dang it. I guess we'll rest up at the waterhole. And I will visit the trader. Villagers welcome you as a rare and welcome diversion. Also proudly lead you to the village chief, who also owns the only shop in the settlement. More painkillers, in case I didn't want the other ones. Another grenade, more fuel, and other things. How am I for fuel in getting to my destination? So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I mean, that would be 8. So I don't really need more fuel. Though if I went 1, 2, because I'm kind of curious about, like, these... this dead end over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah. I don't really need to buy more fuel at this point. From a distance, you spot the deserted temple complex among the dunes. In the sand, you notice numerous footprints, but not a human soul to be seen. Hoping to find more clues, you start to investigate the temple. When soldiers appear around you with weapon drawn, you realize that you have been ambushed. It's a hell of a time to realize. We got blindsided. And we have a Shock Trooper 2 down here. Shock Trooper 3 right there. Another 3 here. Officer 3. A medic here. And then a medic somewhere that's not going to be very useful for them. This is a pretty rough situation, though. Because, like, all of this is pit. So there's very little cover here. However, a lot of them start in positions where they don't have cover either. So, oi oi. Okay. So I almost like the idea of putting Pereira up front and then having him hunker down to reduce all damage by 75%, and then just inviting damage onto him, in a way. But there's only 3 cover spots that I can actually use here. This one, which isn't of any use to me. So really, it's these 2. The other problem, though, is that I was thinking about putting Pereira here and then shotgunning the officer, because he'll be able to do very heavy damage to the unarmored target. I can use grenades here. I can also blast this guy. Stab him. Okay. I'm going to put Natalia here. Baron, I'm going to put there. Miguel, I'm going to put somewhere. I guess I'll put him here, in case I want to run him in some other direction. And then I am going to put Pereira down here, and then I'll decide what I want to do with him. So taking out this shock trooper seems like it would be a really good idea. The straight-up attack with the knife will do 25 to 31, so if we bleed, that should be the end of this guy. And it most certainly is. So we can engage this one. It may not kill this officer, though. It would be a gamble. Damn. Okay. And I've actually placed him too high to throw a grenade all the way down here. This isn't much of anything as far as cover is concerned. The thing is that these guys actually have short-range weapons, so... like, most of our team being up here... well, yeah, they're still gonna be able to get in there and shoot at us pretty easily. Alternatively, I could just shoot the officer. Can I hit anyone else with the burst fire? I can indeed. So I guess I'll do this. Yeah, it's all units in a straight line. Bait isn't going to do anything for me. And first aid is not something that's going to do anything for me, but... you know. Soon. I guess I'll put her up front at this. I wonder if they might be reluctant to take cover here. If we're really stacked up. But her being back there isn't really to her benefit. Get the feeling they're gonna pile on this guy and this guy. Yep. It's 4 armor damage. That's a whiff. And the medic is going to do the medic's job. Which is fortuitous for me, since, well... it's about as good as that gets. Kill 100 Nazis to unlock Leonora. Oh right, it all went to armor damage, and then the rest of it was a miss. So now we've just got this medic, who... well... suppose we'll reload. I do not have things. Jerk. It's a poor move on my part. Well shanked again. What an interesting journey. Okay. Oh, jeez, which one of these Preston grape grenades do I want to equip? So Miguel is leveled up. We can go with Dexterity for better capacity to hit things, Agility for better movement characteristics, or Willpower, which does what again? Number of bravery points used to execute special abilities. See, if he was at 3, I would much more seriously consider it. Most of the bravery skills use 2. I mean, I say that as I mouse over this, which requires 1. But one of the big problems that I've been having with Miguel is his ability to get around in combat. And positioning is important, so I will happily take agility here. And I am going to visit this little town. See if there's anything out here. A fortified camp. The desert camp ahead of you is stacked with crates and fuel containers. You also see some trucks and jeeps nearby. There's no doubt about it. You found an important German army supply dump. There's minimal activity in the camp. It's quite possible that you could reach the supplies unseen. So we can gamble and sneak up to the fuel dump. Or we can just straight up attack. So I get the feeling if we attack, then we're going to have the advantage. But if we sneak up, I think we'll be able to get fuel and supplies, that sort of stuff, without having to fight for it. I can't resist a good gamble. You move forward carefully? You mean sprinting and yelling, hup, 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 as you jump over things? Yeah, that's moving forward carefully. Using whatever cover you can find, you soon reach the supply dump, but as you are about to search it, you hear somebody clear their throat behind you. You turn around in dismay. You have been discovered by the camp garrison. I don't regret anything. So we've been blindsided. We have a sniper here, and one here. We have an officer here, and then a dog here, here, and another one down here. Okay. So, I'm going to put Natalia here, I think, and try and shoot the dog. The Baron, I will place here and shoot that guy. Miguel, I guess I can put him here or somewhere. And then Pereira, right up there. Okay. So this does put her out. She's right in the middle of the open, but sacrifices need to be made. Pereira here can easily deal with the sniper. Miguel. Oh, so close. So close to being able to shoot both of them. That's unfortunate. And then I think we'll need to double shot the officer anyway to kill him. And that just leaves the sniper and 2 dogs. Ugh, one of them is an attack dog, 3. I could use ambush instead to prevent him from doing anything. An interesting thought. So I won't be able to shoot at this one, I can shoot at this guy. However, I can throw a grenade and not hit this guy. So I won't do that, because that seems really daft. So you can shoot him, Where are the other dogs? One here and then one all the way up there. So this dog is going to be able to attack Pereira. And this dog isn't going to be able to get anywhere. I could instead do warning shots to prevent the dog from coming any closer. And then we won't take damage. Why don't I try this set of actions. So we'll cover these guys with ambush. They might both move, at which point I'll shoot one and the other one gets movement. And then hopefully the warning shots will prevent the dog from attacking here, but... So the sniper has set off ambush. So if we sprint, we can get over here to this guy. Which I guess 30%? Oh yeah, I guess he gets cover from the other side of that. Yeah, so we'll sprint to the side of the lorry, and then shoot this guy. No crit, so he's not dead, but it's fine. I'm gonna have to deal with these dogs, though. So this one... I could also go for the officer, but... the dogs do a lot of damage. So we'll take cover here, and take out that one, and then here, yeah. And then I can either engage the officer for 27 to 30, so that's not going to kill, but I could kill here. I could also rush this guy and then stab him. Which I think is going to be the option I'm going to go with. And I don't believe... he might get lucky. Yeah, so the bleed will kill him on the next turn. And we only have the sniper. Who does take an opportunity to shred a little bit of... he took some health off of him as well. So that's 6. And a punch will finish this guy off. Cool. Well, I mean, it's probably a better outcome anyway, because then we get experience for fighting the Nazis. And we get the goodies. Oh, yeah. So, an improved bulletproof vest. +1 vitality, good armor characteristics. Tarnished Oakfield Gernsback gun. Some supplies, an iron cross, and the cart fuel. When the last enemy lies defeated on the ground, you search the camp. Surely you will find some fuel here. Yeah, we do. It's another 3. So, the Gernsback gun is... wow. I mean, it's just better. Basically. Another 4 armor shredding, has 1 more tile of range, and some added crit damage, which is real nice, so. Yeah, you can keep it. This one, though, we will not be keeping. Sell this one, and then pop that one in there. I'm tempted to keep this in case I have, like, more people using pistols, but then I can always strip them off of people and put them into the inventory, so... let's just sell it. And on that same note, I'm gonna sell the compression bandage. I have 9 supplies. I think I'm going to use this to repair a little bit of armor. And then we'll hit the dusty trail. You've been making good progress, so you're in high spirits when you take a short break. After a quick meal, you're about to continue your journey when you make an unpleasant discovery. The sand and rocky ground around your jeep is soaked in gasoline. A hasty inspection confirms your suspicions. A pebble must have hit the tank at full speed and ripped open a small hole from which gasoline is now slowly dripping. The hole is quickly plugged, but the damage is done. Lost 2 fuel. I was actually just thinking, and I was about to say before I started reading there, the fuel that I got from this camp is... I mean, it's nice, because I think I got fuel from the combat, plus I got fuel from the event. But going out of your way to get fuel somewhere like this doesn't seem like that great an idea, because it's like, okay, well, I needed to spend fuel getting here, and then it's almost like you spend all of it getting back on track. You are not sure whether the desert bunker is still occupied, so you carefully sneak closer. Upon closer inspection, the structure looks abandoned. Then you hear whispering sounds behind you, and you realize you are not alone. Blindsided. Okay, so we have a level 3 zombie, level 2, level 2. We have one infected way down here, and then a level 3 cultist who is right up front and center. Okay. So let's put Natalia here, and then I guess we can put Baron up here. Miguel? I'm not gonna need cover too much of it anyway. And then Pereira up front. Okay. So Miguel can grenade these two. Though it's only going to kill the zombie too, and not the cultist. And I can just blast the cultist with the shotgun, which will surely kill. And, yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. And then, let's see. This one's still standing. Impressive. This one is going to be able to advance on our position and then probably spit at us, which is a little bit irritating. But we can fix that quite easily. Yeah, well, I mean, that was the combat. Easily dealt with them. So, free stuff. Alright, sniper rifle, some petroleum, and a stained diary. And I think I made this comparison before. On raw damage, it is scarcely better, but then worse in other attributes that I value more. So we'll not keep that one. What do we got? The village was obviously abandoned years ago. Its well is silted up. The roofs of the huts are falling in. You search the huts in vain for anything useful. A loud call makes you jump. Pereira is standing in the courtyard of the largest house and is waving you over excitedly. On the ground in front of him, you see a stone slab with an old iron ring in its center. Possibly the entrance to a cellar? Let's pull on the iron ring. What's the worst that can happen? Try as you might, you cannot budge the massive stone slab. Frustrated, you leave the village. You hear the guttural bleating of the desert goats before they emerge from behind the next dune. The lonely herd wanders this desolate wilderness in search of its next poultry meal. Aw, it's on the jeep. How cute. A huge cloud of dust slowly moves towards you. Confused? You come to a stop. A large convoy of trucks is headed your way. It must be the Germans. You hastily take cover in a nearby depression. The noise of the engines gets louder. After what seems like an eternity, the engine noise fades into the distance, and you breathe a sigh of relief. The Nazis didn't spot you. I was going to say, like, what's confusing about a massive cloud of dust in the desert? Have they not heard of sandstorms? Actually, I suppose that's true. Because that song wasn't, that song wasn't made until much, much later, after 1936. At an oasis, you meet a merchant who is very eager to sell you his merchandise. Alright, well, we get another crack at this new sheepskin vest. I'm still uninterested in it. Worn battle dress. Worn bulletproof vest. Some supplies, and some fuel. None of which I particularly need. I'll happily sell you my wares, though. Okay. Here we are at our destination. At the foot of the mighty mountain, you finally find the vehicles of the Nazi expedition parked by an old mine entrance. You have reached your destination. You park your own vehicle behind a rock and cautiously sneak closer with your weapons drawn, but you do not encounter anybody. After a long trek through the enormous mine, you hear voices. You sneak closer and hide behind some boxes. The hall is teeming with soldiers. You hear a loud shout. A detachment of soldiers runs into an adjoining room. You crane your necks, but you cannot see what they are doing there. Ooh. Suddenly, you feel the muzzles of several rifles being jammed into your backs. You've been discovered! The patrol escorts you into the stone chamber. The soldiers and a senior officer are standing there around a huge, sprawling device. The officer's face lights up when he sees you. Delightful! I do love company. Please, come closer. You see, this is the problem with these old myths. You never know what to expect. The wrath of God, presumably an artifact of untold power. Deadly power. If you understand me. The officer points casually towards the object. I'm sure you can appreciate that I am reluctant to risk the lives of my men. Perhaps you might help me. The officer nods to you encouragingly. You look around to see several rifles pointed at you. You have no choice. You approach the strange object. It is covered with arcane devices. In their midst, you see a bizarre yet fearsome-looking object. Is this the mythical wrath of God? What will happen if you take it? Miguel shrugs and grabs the artifact. Then everything happens very quickly. Among the startled shouts of the surprised soldiers, you also hear Miguel's cries of pain. The wrath of God glows red in his hands. In a swift motion, Miguel hurls the weapon aside. You take cover, anticipating a German counterattack. Okay, so we have a Tesla Borg over here and over here. There's a sniper on the far side of the machine. And on the near side, we also have shock troopers here and here. And an officer down there. So it's unlikely we'll be able to push down to get out of here. We could move to the left, or we could go to the right, though there's going to be more trouble over there. I think moving right is going to serve me best in this situation. I mean, other than that, or I'm going to charge down here and take out these guys without the armor. I would really like to deal with the officer sooner rather than later so that he's not giving them extra turns or extra attacks. So that might be something to consider. And now that I have considered it, I think I will do precisely that. So I'll put Baron and them kind of like right here, and then Miguel and Pereira here. They won't be able to shoot at me because of the tumult. But they will reposition here. Okay. This guy's got a lot of armor, though. So we'll have to find ways of dealing with him. So we can move here, which will put him... Ooh, actually. This is rough all around. So Pereira will have a 75% chance to hit this guy, and isn't able to engage this one. He'll be able to kill the sniper if he manages to hit him, and 75% isn't terrible as far as odds go. So I think that's what I'm going to do with old Piranha. Nice. Okay. So we're not going to be able to kill the Baron in one, or the officer, in one turn unless we gang up on him. And I do want to do something about this shock trooper. So I think what I'm going to wind up doing... I could put Baron here and then have him stab. This will maintain cover both on this side in terms of visibility, but then anyone shooting from this side will have, you know, issues hitting him because of the cover. And then that might give us some opportunity to shoot this guy? No. Well, we could throw a grenade at him. And then shoot him with a disruptor. Okay, let's move Miguel down here. And then... yep, so we can throw this grenade. So that really chews through this guy. And then we can use sprint with Natalia. Finish the officer off. And then Baron. I'm not sure where I want to go. So the Tesla Borg could go to this spot right here on the wall, at which point he'll be able to peek. Actually, really, he's going to be able to engage. Definitely Pereira, maybe not Miguel. I'm just concerned about Baron being here and getting shot at by, like, the other three that are up here. So, yeah, I think I'll move here. And then this will have to be a bleed with a knife. And winds up being a crit, so. Great. Now we've only got four. And this one is not able to do anything, as expected. Oh, nice. That actually plays really well for us. Because evades give you back bravery, which means that I can dash over here and stab this guy with a bleed. Which I am definitely going to do. Well, yeah, no, I am definitely going to do that. Ugh, it's like the minimum roll. Might not actually die next turn. Okay. Here and retreat behind some cover. And then we can put Miguel over here. Natalia. Oh man, this sniper is just like not having any of this combat. Go from there and see what happens. Oh, nice. Okay, so this guy moves up to the cover. And this guy moves over there. Really? I won't be able to hit him from here because I can't see? What about the peak shot? Because, like, I can peek from here and see this guy and shoot at him. That is very strange. Okay. Well, this is definitely a good spot, though. Though that is some nasty armor reduction. I'm still gonna shoot at him. Oh, nice. The Baron with the crits. What a boss. I don't know, I almost get the feeling that, like, the display is wrong. Like, I should be able to shoot him from here. I'm gonna try it. See what happens. Nope, I can't see him. For some really bizarre reason. Oh no, wait. It says chance 100%, but he's, like, in... Like, he's not in the fire zone. That is weird, man. So, like, the game tells me that I'm not able to attack him. And yet, yeah. Well, who knows? Let's see if we hit him here. Not bad indeed. So I don't think I'm gonna be able to advance on this guy to the point where it'll be useful, but I do want to move up a little bit. Cool. Okay, the sniper is doing nothing. And this guy also doing nothing. Okay, can the sniper actually... No, he can't because the machine is in the way. Alright, well... Guess we'll move Baron up here. And then we'll have Pereira move up and stab this guy. Quite so. Miguel will just move this way. And I'll have Natalia take low, high cover here. Knife to meet you. Swing and a miss. Ooh. I have ideas. Sweet. As the last soldier falls to the ground, you look at each other in disbelief. You actually did it! But you don't have much time. A loud creaking noise warns you of another impending danger. The monstrous construct did not survive the battle unscathed. Well, how was I supposed to know the firing disruptor right next to it would be a bad idea? So we get a splendid Steiner pistol. Oh my god, that is splendid. Look at the damage. Oh, it's so good. And then another stylish assistance coat with agility. A stack of cash, penicillin, and a rusty can opener. Epic. The whole place could collapse at any moment. Well, hold on a second, I need to grab this rusty can opener. You run as fast as you can to escape the collapsing masonry. Only when you've reached your jeep do you have time to catch your breath.
The artifact should be buried forever under tons of rock. Your only consolation is that the Nazis will never get their hands on it.
Alright, so our time taken was this. whatever that means. Like maybe 7 hours, 468 minutes and 3 seconds. Who knows? We killed lots of Nazis and other things that were not Nazis. Oh man, look at these valuables. You know, at the end of Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade, walks away empty-handed. No grail, no nothing. At the end of this, sure, we didn't have the Wrath of God, but we've got a rusty can opener. We used 80 fuel, 141 ammunition, collected 31 items, about 10 grand in 1936 dollars, which is pretty good. Bunch of experience, dealt a whole bunch of damage. I feel like there's more stats that could be in here, like how much damage did I take, right? Because total damage dealt as a random stat, like, unless I play this game a whole lot, I'm not going to know whether or not this is good or great or anything like that. I'd love to know what it is in comparison. I mean, obviously, I did not take 7,000 damage. It's going to be much less. Much, much less. I would wager it isn't over 500, and that's being generous. But, yeah, 5 evades, 25 crits. Baron was just knocking these out. Cool. So that is A Friend in Need and The Wrath of God. So the next one will be The Knight of the Black Pharaoh.